USA Warrior Stories is a not-for-profit organization designed to record, archive, and share videos of veteran stories, to help veterans make a connection with one another, and to help us all better understand their sacrifices for our freedoms.
Leyte Gulf, across the restless wilderness of water that is Pacific in name only, the United States Navy orders Halsey's 3rd Fleet and Kincaid's 7th Fleet to the Philippines. Sailing over the Mindanao Deep and into Leyte Gulf, Allied soldiers and sailors come to answer the prayers of those who marched their way to death on Bataan 2.5 years earlier. It is October 1944.
This is a picture of my dad and his best friend. They grew up in the house next door to each other, my dad in uniform, and the man we call Uncle Joe. I'm Diane Blomquist.
And I'm Susan Palimas.
We are the Sisters Loglisci.
We're Frank's girls.
On March 2nd, my dad will be 100 years old, and he is now living in a senior living center, and he would kill us if he had any idea we were doing this.
Yeah.
We're doing it behind his back. He's a very reserved man and yeah. Would never want to be in the limelight for anything.
He grew up in Brooklyn, 200 Clifton Place in Brooklyn. And he was there until he went into the service. He signed up for the service in December 1941. And he had to wait until March 2nd to actually get in and serve. So he was signed up, but he was waiting to get in.
My grandmother wouldn't sign for him to go in early.
She wouldn't sign for him to go in early.
So at 21, he went in.
And I think he trained in the
Great Lakes. He went to the Great Lakes. Yeah, that's where he trained. In the Great Lakes. He said it was really cold up there. And then he went out to San Francisco. And he left from San Francisco.
He was at Pearl Harbor before he left.
My father's younger brother.
He got the
wanted
local.
To serve, but
he
my grandmother wouldn't sign for him either. He was only 17, so he got the local
town drunk
to sign.
He was on a leave getting ready to ship out, and he found out that his brother Joe Loglisci was looking for him. So he asked if he could get a couple of hours to go see his brother before he shipped out.
He was a kid.
And that's when he told him he had no money. And so he lent him his last $10. And that was the last he saw him for like 4.5 years later.
My dad, Frank Loglisci, served aboard the USS Caldwell and shipped out from Pearl Harbor to the Pacific and was aboard that ship for 2 years.
When he was under fire, his job was manning the 40 millimeter guns. And when he wasn't under fire, his job was baker. He was a baker first class.
Two jobs, two hats. That's where he met Father Jack. This is Father Jack. They called him Father Jack because he was a very religious guy. And he was a boxer. So because they were bakers, they would bake the bread for the crew. And you have to, punch down the dough. And as a baker and a big guy, Father Jack said to my dad, I'll do all of the yeast stuff and you do the rest of the dessert stuff.
And he had incidences where they took in flour with cockroaches in it and
flour
worms and bugs and what have you. So they just had to work with what they had. And he did go to the ship's doctor and asked him if it was okay. Is this healthy? Is it okay? And he said, yeah, it's protein. It'll bake off. You'll never know the difference. But he never ate bread the entire time he was on
he
board
ship on crackers.
Because he knew what was in it.
Destroyer men saw them first at Leyte Gulf and then at Lingay. But at Okinawa, they descended like locusts. The Japanese called them kamikaze, the divine wind.
One of the battles they were in, there were three men to a gun. And one of the man that was with him was 18 years old, I thought he said.
Very young.
And he's young. It was his first time, seeing action, and he froze completely. He just completely froze. And so they just picked him up and pulled him away, put him in a corner, and the two of them tried to work on it themselves.
During the Battle of Leyte, his ship was hit. Well, they were hit by kamikaze.
Yeah, they were hit by kamikaze, so that was one of their jobs, to shoot down the kamikaze pilots.
His sister ship was sunk. They lost 33 men.
33 were killed and 40 men were wounded.
2 years and 7 months after General MacArthur had left the Philippines, he kept his promise to return. On the 20th of October, 1944, his forces invaded the island of Leyte.
And what's the sister ship? And the rest of the convoy had to leave them there.
They lost radar, and they couldn't go faster than 10 knots, but they made it.
He got home. He wound up in Penn Station. He called a cab.
This is crazy.
And the guy asked him where he was going. He told him 200 Clifton Place. And the guy said, wait a minute, that's where my aunt lives. And he turned around and he goes, Frank, it's me. I'm your cousin.
That was the taxi driver.
He was the cab driver. So these were things he started to tell us. Just
recently.
He never talked about the war until recently. For years, he worked for Union Special Machine Company. And from there, he became the district manager there. And from that, he was called to FIT, Fashion Institute of Technology. I think he was there 35 years. And he was with my mom until she passed away for almost 60 years. He's a great family man. He's always been. He's been there for everything mm-hmm. with us, every single thing.